What I'm showing you is that I'll tell you the truth, that since I've been doing this for the last 5 to 6 years, what's happened is that, I mean, it takes a lot to do all of this. Like, you're constantly studying, you're constantly in meditation, you're constantly taking care of, I have a wife and a daughter, and then you're constantly preparing for these shows, which actually take a lot, and you're constantly answering emails, and you're constantly, and some people need to think about, well, how much am I really doing? Like, instead of being critical all the time, just think about what my workload per se really looks like, and why I have to use every single thing at my disposal in order to serve humanity's expansion, okay? And so what that's caused, though, is that I have a large amount of information. What's published is about 10% of it, so you can, to give you an idea. And all this information is some of the highest levels, or probably the highest level of information that could be available really to us right now as far as expansion. It is the visuals, meaning images, and the textual, meaning books and knowledge in that, in the written form, that prove beyond the shadow of a doubt, once you have the master key, meaning once you're at where you're at now. See, people, you have the master key before you begin to dive back into any of this stuff, because you're going to need discernment to look at it. But after a while, you're going to see that, man, he's right, or it's right, or the whole expansion and the truth is right. That all people have really been doing that belong to these cults and factions and religions is actually using the knowledge that comes from our body and comes from the universe, and then haven't even been doing a great job at explaining it. And so what this has bred is this bred what we know today is all these complex mythologies and creatures and organisms and things, and many of which only exist within our mind, while we're in a sense diverted from the truth to the matter, meaning which that's what you should be studying first. If you don't have the truth or the master key, when you go into anything, even for some jollies, it's going to serve to even throw you off balance. And so remember, the truth is all itself. So I'm just showing this here, and this is just the images, because it gives you an idea what will become open source, because I also do need individuals' assistance, which you don't have to email me about. We're going to have something major in how we get involved with people to be able to assist us with this. But it's basically taking this and beginning to label it, because while I was collecting a lot of this information for the past 8 years from different places, like I would be going into books that you're not going to see again, or books that you're not going to be able to find again. And then what I was doing is I was clipping a lot of the different kinds of information that was in those books. And then I had no choice but to keep moving on, because sometimes I will go through a book and the book would have like 200 images that I need to clip all in that night. And so trying to actually label all those images, you'll see you get like this, the Adobe Acrobat screen snap, meaning that I can only just have time to screen capture it and then keep moving on. And this has been going on for 8 years. Now, many of these books I read, most of the meat in these books. So when people hear me talking about spirituality and hear me talking about what is really going on, it's not because that all of a sudden I become very judgmental about just religion and about other people's cultures. It's because I took the time to study, and to not just study, but to experience other cultures, but to still, by being empathic, feel that there was something going on that was hindering a lot of the energy that would generally be associated with if you've tapped into this kind of energy. Meaning, what didn't really make sense to me was this glorious explanation of what spirituality really is, but the lack of use of it in the visualization of it in our physical world. Meaning, if we can explain what it would be like to be expanded, why can't we experience that here on the planet? Is there something else here that is attempting to hold us back from that, even besides us? Is there a certain culture, a certain craft, a certain religion, a certain way of life, and a certain way of being that we've adopted somehow in our path of expansion that has been somewhat cyclic for us, or meaning not allowing us to progress? Has it been circle, meaning the actual serpent that pulls the energy away from only the precious things, or the cream of things, or culling away from the top, the tenth, as they call it, the only wanting the chosen part of things, right? Like if the cultures and the religions that have been made available to us, that we've learned it from that, and thus we've become like that, then that's every single thing that we're going to need to get out of, right? And so who is going to be the one that walks everyone out of this level of mysticism, since it involves languages, codes, and craft in which we don't understand at this point because we're dumbed down to English or Anglish? And what it really is that it's something that one cannot do on their own. It's something that we have to do together, and that's what open source spirituality is really about. It's about us all having to utilize what we know thus far to cipher through all the highest levels of knowledge that have ever been available to man coming across this planet that has been written. So I don't think personally that there's any other annals or any other documentation that is more rich than our archives at this point, beside probably the 5 Mile Library underneath the Vatican. So what happens here then is that the expansion begins, and the information, instead of some Snowden crap, meaning, and I'm not saying anything negative about Snowden, but I still think it's a massive op, but instead of information that basically only tells you things that you can't do anything about. Oh, they're looking at you. They're watching you. There's nothing you can really do about that then, unless you just hide under some aluminum foil or something. But the reality is that the same thing with the leaks, you know, who's doing bad and who's the one that's corrupt. And I guess for the low level of consciousness and what they need to know to just basically find somebody else to blame, that suffices. But to the other levels of consciousness, because I was talking to some individuals and I said, hey, you know, let me ask you this. In all the information that was sequestered from different systems, did you ever come across any spiritual knowledge or spiritual information? The remark was, we weren't looking for that. Well, come on here. If the only thing that can really expand us is knowledge about ourselves, why are we looking for knowledge about them? Why wouldn't we be looking for knowledge about what is going on with our physical bodies? Why are we even here? Let's start with that. Let's let that be the main query that we search all databases for, is that, hey, why are we here? But of course, that doesn't happen. What generally happens is one attempts to acquire a lot of information that allows them to blame someone else for the reason or the reason why they have not succeeded, or the reason why they failed, or basically the whole conspiracy portion of the whole thing, right? Yet many of us now are like, okay, I'm looking for the knowledge, I'm looking for the information that's actually going to give me the real truth about what's going on here, and then like what's really happening. Am I going to have the opportunity to really expand, or is this going to be going on like Groundhog's Day like indefinitely? And of course, in the program, that's how it's rigged. As I told you, there was a king who's Cohen, who was the priest, who decided that during its reign that it wanted to make its reign forever. And this is very interesting, because if you notice how the zodiac is set up, is the zodiac is set up that certain beings actually reign during certain time on physical planets, because they're the energies that emit during that time, like seasons, okay? But what happens if we're only in summertime and there becomes no spring, there becomes no winter, there becomes no other seasons in a tense to give us some new flavor? And so this is kind of like what's going on with Earth, because Earth is stuck in a time where one particular king decided, well, I want to make this an infinite golden age, which is my color. And from here, the gold gods will rule. As you notice, if you take L away from God, take L away from gold, it says God, okay? And then you take, so God has an affinity for gold, and you turn God backwards, it means dog. So that means that they probably came from Canaan, because they're canine. And then you get into this whole black dog mythology, and basically the sign of the dog, which is basically a domesticated lion when you really look into it, because notice how cats are a mixture between lions and snakes. And this is why their eyes have the vesica. But lions have circular eyes like humans. And so the dog with a circular eye, if you trace back Canis's genus, it actually gets into lions. And so this doesn't mean a black man or a white man, but really that they're black and white are derivatives of the lion beings. And that's why even Haile Selassie and all the Rastafari are over there with the lion. But in Britain, they just throw up the lion in your face like it belongs to them. And it's because of a war that has been going on, an inner war within our consciousness that is taking place in the worlds within, known as the chakra, or the archonic planes. And that these worlds are the battles of deities attempting to rule over who? You. And so this is how they fight their war. They fight their war by seeing if you're going to adapt their way of being, their laws, their rules, their edicts, their customs, and their dominion over your soul. So what then happens is that we get a chance to release ourselves from this kind of vampiric dominion and get into each other, into experiencing who we are, not creating differences based on cultures that came through one time of the zodiac on a dualistic planet and then wanted to iconoclast their entire experience with us by continuously giving us the knowledge and information only about them, but not about ourselves. And that's why I was saying it doesn't matter then if it's about God, if it's about Hercules, or if it's about Spider-Man. If it's not about you, then it's the same play. And that's how we have to realize what we're dealing with. But of course, I've been able to furnish the documentation that allows you to see that. That is in this these disclosure statements, because it'll show you beyond a shadow of a doubt that the individuals that are involved in this, again, have the creativity to begin to put things together. So you won't even know what is what. You get some artificial structures here, you get a few artificial books, and then next thing you know, you're bowing down. So this means that you don't have to necessarily figure out who's who and what's what. You just need to figure out who you are. If you're still bowing down, if you're still looking to something else to give you something that you're supposed to be getting yourself, then you're actually tied into the whole vampiric session. Right? So what this progression is about, what we're doing is we're making it open source, every single thing that was held back from us, starting with us, rather than starting with someone else's story, starting with the Earth saga first, so that we can figure out who's who and what's what and the connections between everything, why people can't see that Seth was a dog and it was a Sethian dog, and from that point that the dog put itself on the ark and that the humans thought that they were going to bring their cone or their offerings to him, so that way he can use that same cone as a wedge, as you see in the Sumerian, the wedge to get into our state of consciousness. And this is also what we talked about last night. So again, some didn't hear the conversation from last night, so we're going to replay that conversation, and then next time we have a show, which actually may not be in 2 weeks, it may be in a month, because I want to make sure all this stuff is together. And what I'm doing right now is I'm starting the first round of sorting this information, so that way the others that come in to assist me in doing it can also understand even what's here. But to give you an idea, this is a document, this is a database software that is incredible. I am able to, and this is just my images, and I've got them somewhat sorted at this point, and this is not all of them, but it allows me to take my images and put them into a way where I can not only access them rapidly, OCR, anything that has text in it, meaning optical text recognition, allows me to see that that's what this says. So if I'm looking for a minute again, then I'll actually be able to type that in my search bar and actually get that. And so, and this will be done with all of my documentation. It'll be done with all of my books, which have now reached around 20,000 spiritual books only. This is not even, you know, science and all those things. It's just only spiritual books. My documentation has reached that amount. But the imagery to me is worth more, because now people become very visual with what they believe to be true, right? And so because of that, then you have to show them visually, look, there's a priestcraft going on here. And the priestcraft has learned this language that they got from the Egyptians. It was one of the things that they actually took. And then from that point, they can actually confine entities into vessels and trap them. They were like fishers of men, if you may, trappers. Okay, in the trap, but doing it with souls. Okay, and the same thing, that the reason why that these same men are over the rap or rape industry is because they work the craft through tones and vibrations and trapping individuals into a certain state of consciousness that repeat themselves over and over and over again. Like somebody can probably repeat the entire song of Drake's first single, but if you ask them where in which they come from and how in which do they get about, they don't know anything. So that is a sure play. And also, if no one is here explaining to you what is actually going on, then this means, like, meaning somebody's addressing, even the most powerful people in different states of life, i.e. your president, whatever, if they're not getting up and saying, hey, this is exactly what's happening, and this is where you are, this is the world that you're living in, then you're under some level of deception. And that's why these people, and you got to think about it. I asked myself, because the other day I was looking at this thing where, I think it was Senator Kerry, he was asked if they were basically giving weapons to the opposition forces of Syria. I'm just trying to remember what was going on, because I was mainly just honing into just the whole thing of the energy coming across. And because the lady said, because during the speech of Barack Obama, he actually said directly that that's what he was doing. Is that what you're doing? Right? And this dude sat back there like this and said, well, I don't know. And she said, no, no, no. Is that what you're doing? And then he goes, well, I'm not sure, because I didn't actually hear the speech. Wait a minute. Why is it that we gotta lie all the time. Why can't this man just say, look, we need the oil, we're burning up too much gas, we're very greedy, we need the stuff so you can keep your shit running, and if you don't like it, then go to another country, because that's it. Right? Why don't they just muscle in and just say, hey, this is what it is, and this is why we do what I do. Right? We do what we do, right? Why don't they say that, right? This is because they are in this part of non-transparency, and they wish to remain there. And it doesn't mean that they wouldn't feel confident with just going out and saying that. This just means that they use non-transparency as their tool, as their mode of faction. So don't be surprised then, like I said, when you're watching these people and they're not giving you the real truth about anything, but yet you keep going to their information and acting like their information is going to authenticate something. This is the kind of information that is going to authenticate something. This is the kind of information that's going to authenticate something. Because it doesn't require me to actually believe in what another person's saying. It just requires me to look and to read and to watch the consistencies. It doesn't require me to actually look at one thing and say, that's exactly the truth. It only requires me to log that and then to look later to when I see that exact same thing on someone else. When I start following the signs and the symbols and then where they lead me through the matrix. And then I start seeing, well, shit, this is who, what's what. But don't be surprised then. If when you start bringing truth for others who haven't seen the imagery and you're telling them, look, he was really with them. It was like a whole coup. They were all sitting on the couch together when they were writing all the documentations to enslave you. Then they may even try to murder you for even bringing forth such information without clear proofs, right? So that's what the books said. You need clear proofs. And these are clear proofs, my friends. And in fact, we've been delivering this since day one. But now, as I said before, we take it to another level. And then for you to see, let's just go in here just a little bit. And let's use the drives in discretion. But if we're noticing here, every book about philosophy is here. All of them. They're all here. You see? Everything that was ever written about in the philosophical times is all here, okay? But who wants to read that? It's boring. That's what it was made to be. You see that they wrote it literally to actually be boring and put the person to sleep, make them think, hey, maybe I don't even want to be smart. Maybe I should just go out and get some cows and some stuff and get rich, because, you know, this whole spiritual thing is obviously for somebody else. Masonic. Everything they ever wrote. They sell this themselves, so it ain't like this was pilfered from somewhere. They always say, oh my goodness, this is information that he's not supposed to have. No, this is when you're looking long enough, you'll find that they want money for everything, so they sell you every single book. There's about 5,000 of them. They dwarf, literally dwarf all other spiritual knowledge. These people wrote so much just to shroud out the truth that they have at least 5,000 publications by themselves. And then you get into current readings, meaning like what I'm looking at right now, which was 5 years ago, a consistent procession of me, okay, this is where we're at now, this is what you need to cover. And then once that's covered, then creating another folder, as you'll see in here, and this is all what will be getting sorted out, is creating another folder for the different expansion, right? So this is when I was in this state of mind, looking through all of these books, and this is what I had to read, and this is what I had to cover. And then all of a sudden, probably will pop up yet another folder, and then I'll go even deeper in there. And so the folders are staggered based upon the knowledge that I needed to cover during that period of time. And then when I started getting ready to go into the next round of the expansion, then I would just remove that knowledge, or actually put that knowledge all into one folder, and then go on with it. So there we are. So this is what will be open source, and what it already is. Some people say, well, you better hurry up and get that stuff out. That's the fear state of mind. Oh my goodness, if it's there, you better hurry, because look, it's already in different places where other individuals can just as soon as upload it all and give it to everyone they need it. So don't be worried. But don't be surprised if 5 billion aeons from now you still see me. And it's because that when you are secure within yourself, there is no opponent. You ate them.